proving their leader led the Chorus.
Palmer's no use at all, thinks he's very clever. Says that he can manage us, that's the best joke ever. When he orders us about with the greatest folly, we just push him down the well. Up goes O'Lally.
Thomas, Duck, and Percy were shocked. Be quiet, they ordered. But they couldn't be everywhere, and everywhere they weren't, the cars began again.
Oliver's no use at all, thinks he's very clever. Says that he can manage us, that's the best joke ever.
At last the engines gave up. We're sorry, Oliver, they said. It's really my fault, said Oliver sadly. I shouldn't have fallen in the turntable well. Toad, the brake van, felt sorry for Oliver, too. Next morning, he spoke to Douglas.
I'm worried, Mr. Douglas. This disrespect for engines, where is it going to end?
Who knows, sighed Douglas.
I've got a plan, Mr. Douglas. May I stay here today and help Mr. Oliver? We are both great Western and must stand together.
Certainly, Toad, replied Douglas and puffed away. Soon Toad was explaining his plan. Goodness gracious, Toad, I don't think you should suggest such a thing to Oliver. But Oliver interrupted. No, Duck, Toad's right. It's really my fault. I must put this trouble right.
I meant no disrespect, you understand.
Of course not, Toad. Anyway, driver says the same, and he's arranged it with the station master. Very well, Oliver, conceded Duck. But I must hurry. My passengers will be waiting. Good luck. So long, smiled Oliver bravely. But he felt dreadfully nervous inside. Oliver marshaled the worst cars two by two.
That's the way, Mr. Oliver, whispered Toad. If you leave that Scruffy till last, then you'll have him behind you. You can bump him if he starts his nonsense.
Scruffy has learned his lesson and says nothing